Hi, everyone, and welcome back to the show. Now, sometimes when you're looking at the pantheon of treatments for hair loss, it's easy to get a bit overwhelmed as there's so much to consider. And so it's a really useful exercise to sort of take a few minutes, step back, and look at the big picture so that you can understand where the different treatment options fit in. And so using this as a guide, we can also see how these treatments can be used separately and also in combination with each other. So I wanted to take a few minutes to just to go through that sort of plan so we can essentially determine how we create a strategy for that individual patient. So when we look at these non-invasive treatments, medical treatments, so not including hair transplant surgery, there are essentially five different options for us. The first one being the most common thing that we use, and that's medical therapies. And we've talked a lot about that, those in the past, and they really encapsulate things like the 5-alpha reductase inhibitors, so finasteride, or dutasteride, both the oral version or the topical version. And then there's, of course, minoxidil as well, which acts as a stimulator. And that, again, can be used as a topical or in oral formulation, depending on the individual. Then what we should always consider and make sure we're taking into account is the nutritional support for the hair. And this can be in the form of vitamins. We talk about cyclical therapy, really making sure that we get those nutrients to the hair follicle to help them grow. Mesotherapy is also a great treatment option. There are things that we can use, you know, the act of mesotherapy helps stimulate blood flow to an area, but you can also use that in combination with other treatment options. You can use mesotherapy with things like finasteride or dutasteride, really to help the absorption and transportation of those molecules into the level of the hair follicle. Then we've got low-level laser therapy, great treatment option, very safe, really no side effects, and there's a lot of data and a lot of studies that really show the benefits of the use of low-level laser in helping as a stimulation of hair. And then the sort of new kid on the block, really, is the regenerative therapies. And right now, we've got things like PRP, and PRP's been around for a while, also got a lot of good data to support its use, essentially taking blood from the patient, processing it, spinning it down, and injecting that back in the into the scalp. There's a newer form of treatment called exosomes, which are basically little messengers that will be transported to the hair follicle. And another new type of treatment called the Alma-TED as well, which really does help transport molecules across. So these are the new kids on the block, but really showing a lot of promise in terms of improving hair quality, hair strength, and reducing shedding as well. And so you're not, if you're picking a therapy, you're not sort of picking just one and staying on in that compartment. You can talk about adding therapies depending on the nature of hair loss that someone has, the extent of that hair loss, and what the patient wants as well. So I hope you found this useful. This is sort of a structure in which we can sort of base, okay, how do we decide what is the best treatment option for that individual? I hope you found that useful. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you on the next episode. Take care.